Now let's look at a next slide, which actually discusses what the effects of these aspects are. Now, garbage in, garbage out is a very popular term used in a lot of machine learning courses as well as in technologies as well, because it kind of deems exactly what the problem statement here is. If you're working with incorrect data, it's going to result in incorrect models and incorrect predictions. Let's discuss on garbage in first. What do we mean by the incorrect data? We discussed that at the start. These are the entry points for these data sets. But now let's discuss what exactly these incorrect data sets compile on. Well, firstly, you could have inaccurate data, meaning that the data set in itself is just deemed or perceived inaccurately. A very simple example for this would be, say, coordinate systems or precision tool sets, where correct conversions have to be done in order to ensure that the corresponding data is being interpreted correctly. Incomplete data, as you can imagine, is incomplete data. In a traditional sense, this would be the auto trimming of an address column resulting in an incomplete address. But in terms of models, this could also be in terms of incomplete data in with regards to the number of records that you're trying to cover, or the consistency and the accuracy of the records that you're covering as well in terms of incompleteness. And this, of course, poorly formatted data. Depending on the type of model you're working with, you might be working with a variety of formats. However, poorly formatted here implies that there is inconsistency within these different formats as well. I'm looking at those complex XML, JSON files, which don't really perform a typical traditional flat database system. And instead, you are dealing with a lot of hierarchical data sets and a lot of objects between them. And this usually can cause a lot of issues, as you might have to pull out the information from these specific inaccurate systems inherently. That's one aspect. Bias data is an odd one out in this list so far, because bias data is something that we have to deal with from a non-traditional perspective. I mean, if you look back previously, say you were working on a data pipeline for a supermarket. The data is accurate as it can be. More people buy a particular product. That's not really a bias. That's the truth there. However, when you're trying to train models, at that particular point, it's very important for you to understand that you're working with an inherent bias data set, especially if the questions that you want this particular model to answer don't correlate correctly with the data that you're putting in. That's exactly what the Amazon pointer is in garbage out. That's the other section which we'll come into, and it kind of comes into play there as well. Apart from biased data, we are working with duplicity in our data sets. That's pretty straightforward. No need to have a lot of explanations there. We're working with unstructured data. There can be invalid data points itself. And invalid data is actually a pretty big pointer, as at many points you would like to see not really go ahead with certain records or convert them into specific records that are deemed as a category of records which don't really make a lot of sense in the training data set, depending on the model you're trying to work with. Then there's, of course, inconsistency. Inconsistency is very important, and one of the favorite examples that I have here is in terms of financial systems. Say you're working at an AI model or say an ML model which works on financial systems, but the data set you're interpreting at a global level has different precision units across. Now, these different precision units are going to inherently affect the system unless you ensure that all of these coagulated systems, all these coagulated finances work at the same precision. And that's just one example on how inconsistency within your data sets can handle or corrupt your model itself as a whole. There's, of course, non-conforming data on top of that, and non-conforming data kind of puts in on top of the fact that when you're working with these models, you're never really working with a lot of, say, characters like strings. You're usually going to term or deem them into categorizations. An easy example would be you wouldn't really define genders as, you know, just male or female or any other value type. You would actually define them as categories, 0, 1, 2, and so on. And ensuring that these categories are correctly addressed and correctly defined, and anything outside pertaining categories is caught, that is pretty important, because that's going to affect the corresponding model output as well. Then there's, of course, class imbalance, data annotation errors, and migration induced errors. Out of these three, class imbalance and data annotation are more user defined, because that requires a lot of interpretation of data. The application is going to help you define those as well. And if you're creating a model, this is something that you'll have to work with. But the last one, migration-induced error, is something that a traditional data engineer will be very aware of, but someone who's coming into the field from an ML perspective, where they are preferably just training the data, preferably used to, say, good data, might not really see. And this comes in handy when we were discussing things like real-time deployment of these models. That's one of the things that I'll be discussing in the upcoming slides as well, which is that, well, you know, say you're training a model and everything you get is, well, crisp and perfect and there are no issues in the data. When you're actually deploying it, it's not the case. Migration-induced errors, as we saw in the very first slide that I was trying to showcase, is one of the main issues for a lot of errors that come in. And the fact of the matter is that you're going to get your data sets coming in from variety of sources. And these variety of sources need to be compiled into one system. You might have to convert databases into files into other file formats, and then combine them together into a DB or into a file format the model can actually ingest. And all these transformations and migration itself has a lot of pain points where data could be incorrectly, say, transformed or incorrectly interpreted as well. And that's one of the things that we'll discuss within our systems. Of course, finally, I've added a small caveat that all of these definitions of what we define as inaccuracy or incomplete are bound to change when you're discussing things from a model's perspective, as opposed to discussing things from a traditional perspective where you had sources and then you had transformations and they put them into a BI system and called it a day. So it's not really the same. And so that's why the definitions themselves could be slightly different. And that's something that an end user has to keep track of when they're discussing why they need to improve the quality of data they're working with. That was a bit on the garbage in part. Now let's discuss what the garbage out really means here. And as well, if you have any of these problems, and I mean even just a couple of them, it can result in heavy losses for the end user. And I have the next slide which discusses on the losses specifically, but let's just look at a few of these specifications. Well, the first one is from Unity Technologies, where an ad targeting error, and what they were doing at this point was they were using a model to actually define and who to target. And again, this is very common in marketing schemes, as you can imagine, using machine learning models or AI models to define what subsector or what exact demographics they would like to run with. And in this particular place, we see that Unity's model was incorrectly trained. And because it was incorrectly trained, it was kind of spitting out incorrect targeting values itself. So it was basically not doing the demographics that it was supposed to. And this cost the company about $100 million. And just that just really puts a heavy number on what these machine learning codes can define. Because at the end of the day, while this is a direct impact on the revenue, retraining the models and rerunning the systems itself is a costly affair. And that's something that anyone who has worked in this particular field is well aware of. The Amazon study is actually much more different, and it's based on bias data and actually more closer to the aspect that the biases that you're working with are going to come into your model as well. And here we had noticed that the actual, and this is not just me, this is a study that was done on the Amazon's machine learning system to hire employees and candidates. Well, in that particular case, we saw that any kind of mention of women or say women's chess captain leagues or any kind of other prejudice right there was kind of exacerbated because the data inherently had these biases. And because they had these biases and the model was not trained to, you know, work on against the bias, it was trained to work with the bias. The model had this kind of issue with it where it was preferring male candidates over female candidates. And well, this is one of the biggest issues found. Gender bias was not the only thing. It was also the fact that it did not know how to treat candidates with not a lot of specific experience. So where there were a lot of candidates with just, say, mediocre experience, or just say non-specific would be a better word here, is non-specific experience in general, they would recommend these candidates to every particular job profile. And the reason for this is not really the model, it's the actual data, because the data itself defines what this corresponding resume or what this corresponding system is affecting against. And so that's one of the main differences of a good model versus a bad model. And in most cases, as you will see, and if you actually look at any kind of process of a good model, is the cleansing of data. So that is one of the important aspects of understanding how exactly bad data affects a model with some real life examples as well. This is some studies that we have seen, and these were quite a newsworthy things. Of course, you can Google them for more details if needed.